Thanks for tuning in. Today we're going to be reviewing the Bliz Fusion sunglasses and the Nordic Light lenses. When it comes to cycling sunglasses, there are a lot of options to choose from on the market. However, most of them are quite expensive, which is why we're excited to be looking at the Bliz Fusion sunglasses today. Bliz sunglasses are well known for the technical features and competitive price points. In terms of packaging, you can see it's very nice. You have this leather-like material, a hard cardboard box with a little latching mechanism. This also folds flat, which is a really nice feature. All the specs are written here on the side. And you can also see we have the Nordic lens, which is specifically designed for low light conditions to test as well. Now, while I take this out of the box, we'll go over the specs. Retail price on this is $94.95. And for the colorama variation, which lets you customize the color of the frame and jawbone, that comes in at $104.95. And what's also nice is that the replacement lenses for the Fusion are very affordable. It's about $26.95 to $44.95 currently. In terms of the frame, it's a TR90 gorillamide material, so very flexible and durable. You get a polycarbonate vented lens, so great for anti-fog. And you also get Bliz's hydro lens technology. That's a combination of anti-scratch, hydrophobic, and UV protection. You have an adjustable nose piece, allowing you to really customize the fit, as well as a rubber wire core temple. And this is a nice feature that lets you adjust it and keep its position. These are available in a variety of lens options as they're removable. And we have the Nordic variation here, which I'll pop out of the bag. These are designed for low light or flat light conditions. And as you can see, especially with this violet base, really brightens everything up and improves your color perception. Now inside the box, you get quite a few things. First, you have the nice box itself. You can see it folds completely flat, great for traveling with. On top, you have a little informational card. You have the user manual, which tells you a little about the lens categories, cleaning cloth, a separate jawbone. This is a really nice feature. It lets you actually customize the appearance. So instead of having to have multiple sunglasses, you can simply swap out the jawbone for the white variation here for a different look. You can also run it without the jawbone entirely and just run the separate nose piece for a semi-frameless look as well. So really nice and customizable. And with the colorama option, you can actually choose different colors of the jawbones. So you can go red, turquoise, whatever color variation floats your boat. Now let's take a second to look at the weight of the sunglasses. So with the jawbones installed, comes in at 34 grams, so quite light. And out of curiosity, let's see what the Nordic Light lens weighs in at. And that's only 12. Now let's go over the fit and finish of the Bliz Fusion sunglasses. What's really unique about these, they have an aggressive look with sharp angles. And the Fusion is actually the same as the Bliz Matrix, except for the jawbone. With the Matrix, you get the single nose piece instead. What I like about the Fusion is that you get multiple styles with this right out of the box, so it's easy to mix it up. The frame color we have here is the matte white. You can see it looks pretty good. It's the same plastic frame you see in most sunglass frames these days. And you can see very flexible, so it's pretty resistant to scratching and can handle impact as well. Now, branding-wise, it's pretty simple. You have Bliz on the side, Bliz on the front, and then again on the other temple. The temple arms are hollowed out on the side as well. They're pretty lightweight. It's a simple hinge design, too, so you can see once I get it about halfway, it feels like it's just spring-loaded. You also have the temple arms, which actually angle inward, so a very cylindrical design here. Typically, these are straight. And then with the streetwear sunglasses, the lens itself is straight, but you can see here, it really is almost cylindrical all the way through. Also, if you look at the lens angle, it's pretty steep in the way it's formed, so it gives you a more aggressive look that hides the frame when you're wearing it. You can see there's no interior structure here. The jawbone is removable, and then you have the replaceable nose piece, but no bridge here. It's a pretty minimal design. You have venting on the lens as well, which helps when you're doing slow climb to prevent fogging. And the other nice thing about the temples here is that they're very flexible. You see, even though it looks like it's designed for a smaller face, everything rotates out. And then with the wire core in here, you can actually adjust this and it'll hold its place. So the little wire core on the inside holds its form, making it really easy to adjust to the desired fit and then have it stay there. Similarly, you have adjustable nose piece, and that makes it easy to get the fit you need. Now, in terms of lenses, you get a couple options. They offer a lot of them and they're pretty cheap. As with the retail price of the lens, the sunglasses, the lenses are at most $45, so you can actually buy a multiple of them without feeling guilty. Now, when you pick a lens, the most important thing is the category. So it goes from category 0 to 4, where 0 is a clear lens and 4 is a very dark lens. The idea with the lens category is the VLT, which is a visible light transmission. The more you let through, the more transparent it is. So with this, I have the smoke with red multi-lens. This is a category 3, which is a pretty nice general purpose one, especially for sunny days. And you can see it provides good protection from the sun. We also have the category 2 Nordic lens. And this is a really cool lens. You can see that it really brightens everything up. So when you're picking a lens, it's the category of the filtering as well as the base color for the lens itself. I also want to show you how to swap out the lens with this. So you can pull the jawbone out by pulling off the sides and then lifting out. It gets easier after the first time you do it. So you can see I have the jawbone off. If I wanted to switch it up, I would simply put another jawbone in here. And then you can see that will switch up the style. And everything clicks into place pretty easily. So now you can see a very different style to the sunglasses. And then you can also go with a semi-frameless look by putting in the separate nose piece. So that's another nice feature. So you can see I can slide this in. And then now I have a completely different look again with a semi-frameless design. What I like about this is when you're riding, you don't see the bottom frame at all because it's not there. Now, swapping the lens is also pretty easy to do. You want to lift up on the sides and then pull out. The tabs do a great job of holding it in place. Now, let's do a little comparison between the Bliz Fusion and some other sunglasses on the market. Here I have the jawbone removed and simply the nose piece installed, so you have the semi-frameless look. If we put this side by side with the POC, you can see it's not quite as European. The POC has a very clean design with half the frame actually concealed. A little less angular, more curvy. The Fusion is a little more curvy. You see the sharp lines on the edges and the indentations on the lens. If we look at some other models, we have the Smith Flywheel. You can see similar styling. They all have the same style frame with the adjustable temples. You can see they're quite flexible, but with the Bliz, that wire core means it actually holds its place. So if you see with this, I can rotate it, move it, but it won't stay in place. The other thing is if you put this, the Bliz, next to the other ones, you can see that it's a lot more curved. The temples actually rotate all the way in, where say the Smith has a curved design, but more straight temples. Same thing with a lot of the other ones. The temples are usually straight. This is the Bole Light Shifter. Quite similar to this one, actually. You have that angular look. The Bliz looks like it's a little bit bigger. You don't have some of the details like the laser etching, but you have a nice large frame. And again, the Bliz is a lot cheaper than a lot of these options. The replacement lenses alone are half or less of the price of Bole, POC, or Smith. So definitely a lot of value. If we put it up next to the big one, this is the Bole Chrono Shield. You can see they're both quite big. They're all oversized frames here, but with the full frame design, this looks a little bit bigger and the lens is larger at the corners. So here we have the Bliz sunglasses with the jawbone installed. And now you can see it looks a lot more similar to say the Chrono Shield with the full frame design. So now let's get the sunglasses on the road. We were impressed with the optics. Both the Nordic and the red multi-mirrored lens worked really well. Particularly on sunny days, the red multi-lens has good filtering with good color rendition. We also like the fact that you can mix up the style. So as you can see here, we went with the single nose piece, then swapped it out for the same color jawbone, and then again swap it out for the black jawbone. And what's great about this is for the affordable price, you're essentially getting three different designs for one. Now let's go over the pros and cons for the Bliz Fusion sunglasses. What we liked about it is a competitive price. The Fusion provide a lot of the same styling and features that more premium sunglasses have, about $100 and less than between $26 to $45 for replacement lenses. These are sunglasses you can actually afford to customize and buy different lenses for. We also like the fact they have a removable jawbone for customization. And the fact that they include two right out of the box means you can really mix up the style on the fly. And finally, the adjustable temples and nose piece make it easy to adjust to different size faces. So whether you're small or large, the sunglasses can easily accommodate you. Some of the cons are the visible molding lines on the inside, something we typically don't see with more premium sunglasses. So it's a little bit odd to see here. They also don't sell the jawbone separately, so you have to be careful when you first purchase it and make sure you get the right color scheme. And finally, the Colorama options, although really nice and affordable as well, it's only a couple dollars more than the standard version, is only limited to the frame and jawbone colors. Other companies with customization typically offer logo colors and temple arm colors. Taking everything into account, we'd give the Bliz Fusion sunglasses a 9.1 out of 10. They provide a lot of style without the big price tag they typically have with premium sunglasses. Thanks for watching this review. Don't forget to like and subscribe. You can see more content from us on our website at thesweetcyclist.com, as well as follow us on Instagram at thesweetcyclist. This is The Sweet Cyclist reminding you to enjoy the ride.